Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to the quickest, the sharpest, the easiest, simple subject. Welcome to mathematics. Students, from this video, we are going to start a new lesson. Name is parallel lines and transversal. But this video is just a warm-up video. In this video, we are going to revise the things which we have learned already in our last standards. Okay? So, first, let's revise about a line. Now you know various properties of line. Line is straight, right? Line has two directions. Most important property. Line has two directions. Second, we learn how to name line, naming of the line. Suppose students, there are three points on this line. Point A, point B and point C. How will you name it? Naming of the line, for naming of a line, we have to write any two points on the line. We have to write any two points in any order. For example, you can write name of this line as line AB. What have I done? I took two points, any two, AB. Or I can take another two points like line AC. Clear? What have I done? I took two points, A and C. So, to write name of a line, you can take any two points like line AB, line AC, line BC in any order. Means you can write this in reverse order also. Line BA, line CA and line CB. So, all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These 6 are name of same lines. Clear? So, line has two directions. This is the way how to name a line. Line is infinite at both directions. And the most important one for this year is line divides a plane. Line divides a plane into two parts. Means what? See, this line, it had divided this plane into two parts, this upper part and this lower part. This upper part and this lower part. Clear, students? It has two directions. This upward direction, this downward direction, up direction and down direction. Let us see. Suppose this line is drawn. So it has two directions, left and right. This line has two directions. It had divided this plane into two parts. This upper part and this lower part. So most important thing about line is line has two directions and line divides a plane into two parts. Clear? Suppose I will draw one more line. So this line also will divide a plane into two parts. This part and this part, and this line has two directions. This direction and this direction. So clear, students? Two most important properties we have to use about line is line has two directions and line divides a plane into two parts. Clear? Now let us see about angles. How to name an angle is the most important thing we have to use this year. Suppose I draw an angle. We just have to deal with naming of the angle. Okay, this is one angle. A, B, C. So how will you write name of this angle? Definitely, you will write the symbol of angle and you will write angle ABC, right? But is it the only name of this angle? Can we write it as angle CBA also? Definitely, I hope that your answer is positive. CBA and ABC are name of same angle. So how we are writing name of angle? This originating point of angle should come in between, right? So that is coming in between, and we refer one point from one arm and another point from another arm. One before this originating point and one after this originating point. Now suppose, students, here is one point D on this arm. Can we write name of this angle in different manner? Can we write it as angle DBC? The answer is yes. So we can write name of this angle as angle DBC. Clear? And we can write it in the reverse order also as angle CBD. right? So once again, naming of angle. To name an angle, we have to write this originating point, originating vertex of angle in between, in middle. See, in all of these names, this B is coming in middle. Clear? And we have to write one point from one arm before that and one point from another arm after that originating point. Now consider, here is another point, point E. So can we write name of this angle as angle ABE? Definitely yes, because we have written this originating vertex in middle. One point, any one point from this arm before that and any one point from this arm after that originating vertex. Clear? So we can write it in reverse order also, means angle EBA. Clear guys? As there are two points, we have started with A. So can we take D instead of A from this arm? Definitely yes. So instead of A, we can refer here D also. B always will be come in between, and here we can write E. So name of the angle will be DBE, and we can write it in reverse order, so it can be angle EBD. Clear? All these eight are nothing but name of one same angle. Why I am teaching you these different methods of naming a same angle? Because in future you may deal with such kind of things, then you should not get confused that ABE and ABC, are they same or different? Definitely they are same. Clear? So as a small homework, I am here writing few angles. You just name them. First is this angle P, Q, R, S, P, and second is this angle L, M, N, O, P. I want just name of these angles in different manner. Okay, so we learned or we revised about line and angles. Now let us see, let us revise about opposite angles. I hope you remember what is meant by opposite angles. Opposite angles, whenever two lines intersect each other. Suppose this is line AB, this is line CD, they intersect each other at point O. So how many angles are created here? If your answer is 4 angles, then you are correct. Here 4 angles are created. First one is this angle AOD or angle DOA. I hope you are getting me that AOD and DOA are name of same angles. Clear? Second one is this angle AOC or angle COA. Clear? I hope you are understanding that these are name of the same angle. Third one is this angle COB and angle BOC. Fourth one is this angle BOD or angle DOB. Got it, students? Now suppose, what will happen if here is one more point, named as point E? So can you write this angle DOA as EOA? I hope your answer is positive. We can write EOA as DOA. So here name of AOD or DOA can be written as angle EOA. Got it, students? And we can write it in reverse order also as angle AOE. Now suppose, here is one point, F. So can you write this AOC as AOF? Definitely yes. So angle AOC can be written as AOF, and we can write it in reverse order as angle FOA. So students, if you have understood this concept, here I am drawing a figure. You just have to write name of four angles. There will be only four angles. See, here are four angles. You just have to write name of the four angles in this figure, but in such different manners, and appropriate name should come at the appropriate place, because AOD and EOA are same. So you can write these names in same group, but if you write this EOA at this place, naturally BOD is this angle and EOA is this angle, and these two angles are not same. So if you write it here, it will be a wrong example. So please write appropriate names at appropriate places, or group of name of same angles. I want only four angles, but name of those four angles should be in different manners. So here I am giving names L, M, N, P, O is the intersection point, and A, B, C, D are the points on these lines. So only one figure. Very less homework I have given. Just naming angles. Clear? So I am expecting you will complete it promptly and submit me tomorrow. Thank you, students.